Hello, 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 hello. God bless you. God keep you. Well, it's another day's journey. And hey, it's just one more day. God bless you. God keep all of you. And I had informed you recently that my mother was sick, and then they thought she was going to die, and then she lived, and it was a couple occasions. So Mama died. You know, Mary Jane Willis, she died today. I've been informed that she's dead, and I don't know. I like I said, Mama always said, bring me my flowers where I live. I know Mama wouldn't want nobody standing over her, looking over her now, you know, in no casket or nothing. I believe that we should have just did a, you know, had a picture of her in her healthy times, you know, and had a little memorial service for her like that. But like I said, you know, you're here today, you could be gone tomorrow. Life is short, you know what I'm saying? You got to live each moment. Sometimes as if it was your last, but it's like when you're a Christian and you're trying to live a Christian life, you know, you got to take that. You can't take that literally. You have to kind of pause with that, because if you take it literally, then you'll be doing anything you want to do, drinking, sinning, you know, just doing buck-wild stuff. So I just want to say that, you know, just remember that tomorrow's not always promised to you. That's what Mama always say. Tomorrow's not promised to you. So she always did what she could for that day. You know what I'm saying? She was a really good lady. You know what I'm saying? She really was. Mama baked homemade cakes, homemade pies, and stuff like that. You know, she lived a long life, 90 years old. You know, that's a long time to live. I wish she was comfortable where she lived. I don't know. It's just like things just come, and it's just everything's just coming at once, you know. And you do your best to hold on, you know. And when I first heard it was 11 something a day, you know, and I was like, you know, I had already knew in my mind. I finally got my car repaired, so I was trying to get to church. I wanted to hear the word. Then here it is, somebody called and told me my mama's dead. They didn't want to bury her all in the same breath, you know. And so I just went to church, you know, and I sat there. And thank God I ended up sitting in front of a guy that used to work at a funeral home, which is amazing. And like I said, then I asked, you know, I missed the day of work, so now I called in, and now I got to go to work. And now I got to deal with this, and I got to go to work. And then I got to deal with the car, which the car was fixed, but then the car still needs some work on it. So I got to pray and hope that the car gets me to the destination, and pray to God that gets me back. I don't know. You know, it's one day at a time, you know. I really would like to get caught up in, you know, whoa, you know, that could have been me, and get caught up in there like, wow, you know. Mama's gone. And here's the sad part about it. Mama died today, and this is my kids, my last two kids, this is their daddy's birthday. His birthday today. And he went to church with Mama one time. Boy, Mama thought that was the stuff. He dressed up and went to church with her. She was happy. I think she fell in love with him. Well, you know, you just hold on, you know, just think about it. Somebody posted that on Facebook. What if you was going to die today? I didn't get to get into it. You know, I found that I skipped through a lot of stuff. If it's really, really important, I was talking about something positive, I'll listen. Other than that, I'll just scan on through it. But I got to go out here and mess with this car, then I got to go to work. And it's like, you know, until, you know, I had weeped a lot, and then you weep and you weep, and then somebody's gone, and then the Bible says rejoice. And but I think the reason why it's difficult to rejoice is because that person's no longer there, and I'm not crying over the dead body. I'm not shedding tears over the dead body. I really came to realize that I'm not crying over it, because me and my mother, we have some bad times, you know what I'm saying? We have a whole lot of disappointments, arguments, believe me, arguments, damn near fights, you know, our cuffs, whatever. You know, we had some difficult times, but she was my mother. You know what I'm saying? She was my mother. She raised me. She didn't have to take care of me. And I learned to respect a person. I might not love you and all of that, but I can respect you. You know what I'm saying? Because she took care of me, and I didn't need that one for nothing. You know, we was clothed and we was fed. We lived a wonderful life. You know what I'm saying? I know I did. You know, had cars 15 years old, had money in my pocket. You know what I'm saying? All the time. You know what I'm saying? We ate real well. You know, home-cooked meals. So it was beautiful. So, you know, the tears is in the memories of the good times. You know, that's what I learned. That's for me. It's not in, oh, you dead, and, oh, I wish she was here because she wasn't living. She wasn't fulfilled. She wasn't happy. You know what I'm saying? She's in a nursing home. They wasn't taking care of her. I don't even want to get deep with that, you know. And I'm still trying to figure out, how do you die, and all of a sudden, you're dead, but you make it to a funeral home without any say-so by me or anybody. So how did you get there? But nobody knows. How did she get from the nursing home there when she don't have no insurance? That's a mystery to me, you know. Like I said, I don't like getting involved with death because everybody get money hungry and then a whole lot of arguments and stuff start popping out. So I choose to step away from, you know. Like I said, if a person can do better and you in so much control, then do you. That's all I like to say, do you. Because I don't have time. I got too much on my plate. I got played for my phone. I'm dealing with that. Somebody took some money out of my account, dealing with that. Car got fixed, but then the car is still broke. I'm dealing with that. I got a whole lot of stuff on my plate I'm dealing with. And it's very difficult. It's very difficult to deal with that. And then try to keep your head up when everything around you is just cracking, you know. And I made it to church, and that's what the pastor, it was a pastor, well, it was another pastor, Skype, from Lexington, Kentucky, and he was talking about, you know, perseverance, you know, basically through all kind of storms and tribulations. And, you know, it sounds good for a minute, you know, and it's nice to hear, know who you are and know what you're made of and know your purpose. And it sounds good, but man, I'm going to be real with you. And then, like I said, you know, I mean, this is, I try to help somebody. I'm not trying to say something to be into me, but I'm saying, here it is. I'm going to run through a list with you real quick. My car, every car I've been having has been broke down. And people talk about, whatever. Man, I done had 3 or 4 cars broke down. A helper stole my other car when I was working, which caused me to lose my job. They wouldn't even go show up to court so I could get paid for that, where you stole my car, stole my $60. Turned around, like I said, my mother's dead, my car's messed up, this car's messed up, jeopardized my job, been on the torque, been under the torque down there more than I've been in the car. I'm talking about hell breaking loose and still keep walking. And you know what I'm saying? I try to be a soldier. But it comes to a time where you got to just sit back and say, whoa, you know what I'm saying? You know, they say God won't put no more on you than you can burn. That's all I pray. Don't put no more on me than I can burn. You know what I'm saying? That's all I say all the time. Because I'm not like the average person. The average person can go out here and you can take a drink, or you can smoke some weed, or you can pop some lower tabs, and you can pop some pills and stuff like that. Right now, my choice is not to do those things. But when I'm working and stuff like that, my body be in so much pain, it's pitiful. Pain pills don't even work for me. I'm just in pain. You know, that little Advil, ibuprofen stuff ain't even working. I'm in pain. And I watch people that's walking through with different medications and stuff. And I'm not doing it. So, like I said, this plate right here is very full. And it's a whole lot of stuff to deal with. It's a whole lot. And you keep on hearing people saying, oh, you're going to get through the storm. You're going to keep on hold on. Hold on. All I can say is to people, just hold on. Just keep on holding on. Hold it all. That's the song I played last night when I was tired. Just hold on. So I'm going to go out here and mess with this car. Pray to God they didn't give me where I'm going. You know, and to all the people that have lost a loved one, you know, like I said, this is not for me. This is not about me, you know. It's about taking time to love somebody, taking time to care about somebody, taking and living your life. not just running around here, I'm going to get high top dad, but running around here trying to be an example for your kids, raising your children, helping people. You know what I'm saying? Help somebody that's down, doing some good. That's all I can say, just doing some good rather than doing some bad, you know. But to the mothers and all these people, every time I go somewhere, I was just walking somewhere not long ago, you know, was walking up Beecher. And I looked and seen where the little makeshift grave thing was, you know, and I'm like, wow, you know what I'm saying? And you feel like you kind of, I felt like I'm kind of walking on a tombstone. But then I was like, okay, wait a minute, it's a sad walk. And I'm like, to all the mothers who lost a loved one, to all the cousins, the relatives that lost loved one, you know what I'm saying? You know, I feel your pain. I feel your pain. I understand, you know what I'm saying? But like I said, all we can do is cherish those moments, you know? It's not how you die, it's how you live. You know, it's not how you die, it's how you live. And when you have that person, when you have that child, love that person. Show that person that you care about them. You know, show that person that you care about them. You know, and God bless you and keep you. And like I said, you know, you pray for me, and whether you pray for me or not, you know what I'm saying? So I'm at the point now where I got to pray for myself. I just got to keep on going, you know what I'm saying? You got to keep going. You can't drink. You can't take pills, man. You got to keep going and going and feeling the pain, man. And I'm like, man, y'all just don't know. Y'all just don't know what it feel like. But I can describe it for you how I feel like now. You know how you get your favorite meal? Say you like a cheeseburger. Cheeseburger's dressed. I'm talking about real hamburger. Not no ground chuck. Real hamburger. You know, and you got it just seasoned right, you got your salt, pepper in it, you got one of them big old buns, and you got your hamburger, your cheese, your lettuce, and your tomatoes, and you got your big old dill pickle sitting on the side, you got your big old beverage, your favorite beverage, and you know, you just waiting, you looking at it, you waiting, and you want to get it, and all of a sudden, when you ready to take it and devour it, here comes a dog or something, and they run up and they snatch your food, you know. And that's how it feels when you're alcoholic, you know. It's something sitting in front of you, you know what I'm saying? It's pleasing to the eye, and it's appetizing to the taste, you know. But you know, no. You know, with the hamburger, you have acid reflux. You can't take that burger. It's greasy, you know. You can't have the cholesterol or something in it. You can't have it. No. And that's what it's like to be an alcoholic, you know. If you take something, it can be bad for you. If you ingest it, it can be bad for you. But at the same time, here it is in front of you. It's in front of you, and you want to take it, but you can't. You can, but you have to remember the side effect. Always remember the side effect. It's on the label, side of the bottle, warning, danger, you know. So, like I said, God bless you and keep you, and have a wonderful day. And there's St. Stephen's, I guess they are, they're going to have church today. I don't know who preaches, but that's what I used to catch. St. Stephen's is going to have church at 7 o'clock, something like that, 7. And I think it's the East End, not Thursday. Thursday is when Wichita has church. Cable Street Baptist Church, they have it. I don't know. Sorry, I think Thursday's at 6. But yeah, get out and get the word. Basically, as a matter of fact, is going to have their 7. I don't know if Reverend Skype is going to be the speaker or not, the preacher or not. But yeah, get out and get the word. Get out and get the word from somebody. You know what I'm saying? Lift up your spirit. You know, lift up your soul. You know, think about somebody that you haven't spoken to. You know, some loved one that you need to tell that you love them. You know what I'm saying? Do that now. Man, the worst thing in the world, don't stand over nobody, man. Don't do it. Like I said, this is just a shell. People don't understand that. That's what I tell my kids. This is a shell. When I'm gone, man, I'm gone. My spirit's gone. It ain't nothing but a body. Don't stand over me. I don't want no film. Don't stand over me. What you standing on me for? Especially somebody standing over you and don't like you. Like my mama said, don't stand looking down on me. You know, mama said, bring me my flowers where I live. And that's the same with me. When I'm dead, what good is it? I can't smell nothing when I'm dead. What am I laying a $8,000 casket for? I mean, it to me, nah. $10,000. You're going to pay $10,000 for a casket. If that's your thing, that's your thing. It's not my thing. Money can be used to furnish my kids' education, my grandbaby's education, send them to college, get them some school clothes, get them school supplies, put them in a class where they can learn some instruments. All that money right there could go there. Why would you take and put that much money in a casket that's going down in the ground? Is it really going in the ground? You know, pay some money to be in a building so people can come and look at a dead shell. I'm not there. What are you looking at as a body? You know, bring me my flowers where I live. God bless you. Get out and get the word today. Bye-bye.